Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. I love ultrasound guided procedures, but I have been using CM guidance for lumbar interventional procedures. I tried to switch from CM to ultrasound for lumbar interventional procedures, but there are enormous advantages in precise targeting compared to ultrasound. At this video clip, I'm going to share the CM-guided lumbar transforaminal steroid injection and study basic lumbar CM anatomy and how to manipulate CM angle to optimize the view. Please keep subscribing and studying with us. First, to reduce radiation hazard to operator, X-ray generator should be in the bottom under the table, not the above the table. If the X-ray generator is located above the patient, scattered radiation intensifies to the operator. To reduce radiation hazard to the patients and operator, I tried not to use lateral X-ray beam projection. I prefer to use AP and oblique technique. Sometimes I like to watch the object on counter oblique view. Let's get to the practice. This patient has had chronic intermittent low back pain, and recently he is experiencing left lower radicular pain. He complains pain in left lower back, posterior thigh, calf area. He shows positive SLRT test. In his simple X-ray image, there is a small node at L2 superior end plate. Sagittal T2 weighted in-phase image shows annular tail at L1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, S1, and Schmoes node at L2 superior body. Right magnified image shows most high signal intensity at L4 protruded disc contents compared to other level. High signal means more water content and recent onset of event. This sagittal T2 Dixon water image shows higher signal intensity of L4 protruded disc content. Axial T2 weighted image shows central protrusion of disc at L1-2 and wide-based left paracentral protrusion of disc at L4 level. Left oblique sagittal image shows annular tear with soft disc content migration at the subarticular space of L4-5 interspace. Proper CM setting is crucial for successful intervention. After patient's pose, prone position, and preparation and draping, optimal CM cranial or caudal tilting is the first step of CM setting. Its purpose to compensate individual variations of lumbar lordosis or segmental angulation. Second step is to rotate the CM to the affected side. With this maneuver, operator can recognize the target and plan the needle trajectory. I use long forceps to avoid radiation injury to my hand and arm. This patient is young and have good anatomy, so I select him as the first case because he shows typical normal anatomy. Let's review normal CM anatomy in oblique position. Well-aligned superior end plate of L5, L5 pedicle, L4 pedicle, L5 big transverse process, L4 transverse process, L5 inferior articular process, S1 superior articular process. If I feel that needle tip penetrate the intertransverse ligament, then I need an AP view again. With the AP CM guidance, I can move forward the needle to the target point. With the oblique CM guidance, I can decide the direction of the needle trajectory. With the APCM guidance, I can measure the depth of the needle penetration. Sometimes, I need to check the needle tip by repeated AP and oblique images. If I'm sure my needle reached the ideal target, I connect the contrast field syringe with the spinal needle. While assembling syringes or injecting process, I must stabilize the spinal needle. Contrast media injection is the final touch before steroid injection. Of course, I have to stabilize the spinal needle while I disconnect the syringe. And finally, steroid injection. I have used the injectant mixture of local anesthetics, high concentration of dextrose solution, and triamcinolone. Thank you for your attention.